Hey everyone, Master Griff here. I found something really useful and I thought I'd share it. There's a file that can be run before the start of loading up Apex called the autoconfig. And it allows you to modify specific settings within the game's code, such as max FPS. So for example, I have a keybind set to change my max FPS to 60. So I push that, and you notice on the top right, my frames per second are locked at 60. The other thing that I've bound is on the left-hand side, you'll see the position, angle, and velocity of my character. And I can actually hide or show that while in game just by pressing F9. I have it bound too. The other thing I have is the netcode or a net graph. This is the data that's going in and out of the network. So it helps with debugging any issues I might have with the game. If I'm trying to figure out if it's just Apex or if it's my home network. This is somewhat of an advanced technique, so I advise that you be very cautious when doing this. This is also something that does not get you banned. There are many pro players that actually utilize this technique. So it is widely known, it's widely used. It is not something that it will get you banned. The first thing that you're going to want to do is, if you're in Steam, I'll show Origin in a second, you're going to right-click Apex Legends, go into Properties, and you'll see under General and Launch Options, you have this text box. You're going to type in plus exec space auto exec. And what this refers to is this auto exec is actually referencing a file, and we'll go over that as well. For Origin, you're going to do kind of the same thing. You're going to right-click Apex Legends, click something like Properties, and go under Advanced Launch Options. You're going to do the same text. You're going to do plus exec space auto exec. Going to just save that. Then once you've saved all that, you're going to actually go into the CFG folder of your Apex Legends. It'll be different for everybody. Some people have it under their C slash program files. Mine is just under my solid state here. One thing that you're going to want to do is go under File on your Windows Explorer and do Change Folder and Search Options. And under View, you're going to make sure that you have Hide extensions for known file types unchecked. You want this unchecked because otherwise it'll actually hide the extension .cfg that we need to type in. Once you've done that, you're going to right-click, hit New. You can just do Text Document. Type in autoexec.cfg. I already have mine created, so I'm not going to create that. Once you do that, you're just going to open it up, and I have this already in my autoexec. For example, F5 changes the max frames per second to 60, F6 to 144, F7 is 180, and F8 is unlimited. The other thing is F9 is bound to that display we saw. Again, it's this one on the top left. Every time you press it, it'll toggle on or off. And again, F10 is that net graph. And that is it. Once you save that, you're going to hit save. You do have to restart your Apex Legends, but once you restart it, you'll have F9, the ability to show your velocity, your angle, even your position. This is useful for testing out tricks and just seeing how fast you go. And obviously, there's the net graph, helpful for debugging your network if you have some issues. Now, obviously, you don't have to have all of these. You can have a select few of these. You can remove some of these. The slash slash is a comment. You don't need these. So you could do this, you could do this, do something like that. All of these are not required, so you could have something like this, and I'll actually leave this in the description of the YouTube video below. And if you found this useful, go ahead and hit the subscribe button or the like button, and I'll see you in the next one.